In this video, I will show you how you can make simple IoT weather station using NodeMCU and DHT11 sensor. So without any further ado, let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. From them, you can order your PCBs only for $2. Just upload your Gerber files to their website and then you can choose any color solder mask for the same price of $2, which is sweet. They offer service for 2-layer, 4-layer and 6-layer PCB. You can also order your SMD stencil along with your order. Now they have even started the PCB assembly service only for $7. So click the first link in the video description to learn more. Let's first start with everything we need for this project. First of all, we need something to measure the temperature and humidity. For that, perfect match is DHT11 sensor. You can even use DHT22, it will work just fine. Just make sure to change the code accordingly. Next up, we need a microcontroller, but we can't use any regular Arduino microcontroller. So we will use NodeMCU, which is based on ESP12E chip, which has onboard Wi-Fi capabilities, which is what we are looking for this project because we are working with IoT. Lastly, we need to use a 16x2 LCD with I2C interface for displaying the weather status like temperature and humidity, of course. Now to make this project little more interesting, we will use Blynk application and its library to even display the temperature and the humidity on your smartphone. Now all we have to do is make the connections as per the schematic. You can find more details about this project like schematic and the code on my website. Link is in the video description. Once all the connections are done, you can upload the code to the microcontroller. But before that, we need to set up the Blynk application. So go to App Store on your smartphone, download and log in the Blynk application using your email address. Now create new project. After which you will see a pop-up which says authentication token was sent to your email address, which we will later use during the programming. Now select on this plus icon and add these two gauges. Once you have added these gauges, tap on it and now name it as humidity and you can even change the label. Now select the input pin as virtual pin and select the pin number as V5. Similarly, repeat the process for the other gauge, but now for the temperature and select the virtual pin as V6. Once that is complete, now it's time for programming. Open the code which you can download from my website, link is in the video description, and change the following lines. Here you will put your authentication token which you have received on your email, so just copy paste it over here. Now just put your Wi-Fi name in the SSID and password of your Wi-Fi over here. After which all we have to do is just upload the code and the project is complete. Well, sort of. To make this device look cool, I designed this case in the Fusion 360 and 3D printed it. After which all we had to do is assemble it. So enjoy the montage. So that's pretty much it for this video guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your friends and subscribe for more awesome content like this, and I will see you guys in the next one.